It took her two stories to be declared an overall winner from the 15 participants that entered the competition. One story was about living with a catheter or a Westberg, which is used when a person can no longer control their muscles to either pass urine or feces the normal way. Many live with this condition helplessly, with no idea that the condition can be corrected through a stoma, and that was the essence of the educative story.
I would like to thank the Society for Family Health for the award for recognition. It is a chain of efforts, including those of our newsmakers who opened their hearts and share their stories with us. This award is really theirs.
Another that entered her recognition is that of Joaquin Makana, who had a sensorous tumor in the lower jaw, a condition which pushed her into hiding because of shame, loss of self-identity and humiliation. Her condition was eventually corrected by local doctors through a major jaw reconstruction surgery, which involved partial removal of Makana's lower jaw to be replaced with her rib.
The media has an important role to play in terms of health promotion. As health journalists, we need to educate and arm the public with correct information in order to make informed decisions. And to do that, we also need to upgrade our skills. We need to understand practices, policies, viruses and diseases. And until we influence positive behavioral change, we cannot pride ourselves and say we are health journalists.
Health and Social Services Deputy Minister Juliet Kavetuna, who spoke at the occasion, complimented the role the organization play in the health sector.
We have seen encouraging progress in recent years, advance in large measures of civil society and organizations such as Society for Family Health. It is in particular in the area of malaria prevention, as we are now working towards the elimination of malaria in Namibia.
The society was celebrating its 20 years of existence. Salomo Tenga, NBC News, Windhoek.